As of November 30th of 2025, there are currently 43 volcanoes which are actively erupting around the planet, a total which is one more than were erupting last week. Of these, the volcano with the longest continuously ongoing eruption is Vanuatu's Yasur volcano. It has been erupting for approximately 800 years straight at a low to moderate intensity via both primarily Strombolian and Vulcanian eruptions. This prolonged activity has all occurred from its ever-growing cinder cone, which in that time span has reached a prominence of 306 meters or 1,004 feet. And now, here are this week's top volcano-related news stories. In Hawaii, the famous Kilauea volcano on the Big Island produced another multi-hour-long episode of sustained tall lava fountaining, with lava fountains reaching peak heights of 600 feet. Meanwhile, in Indonesia, a magma intrusion is likely ongoing at the Burni Telong volcano, but a weather-related natural disaster has temporarily made monitoring this volcano quite difficult. And in what is this week's top story, the largest explosive volcanic eruption so far of 2025 unexpectedly occurred in Ethiopia, generating a plume of ash that eventually drifted over Mount Everest. This major eruption occurred at Hayli, Gubbi, a shield volcano with prior suspected Holocene eruptions, but zero previous confirmed historical eruptions. The eruption in question began at 11:22 a.m. local time on November 23rd, when molten rock broke through the surface in a powerful explosion at Hayli Gubbi's summit, giving way to a towering and continuous eruption plume that reached upwards to a height of 14 kilometers or approximately 46,000 feet. Lengthy pyroclastic flows were generated by collapse of dense portions of the eruption plume, seemingly scorching an area of 15.82 square kilometers. Multiple explosions occurred across the 7.5-hour-long sustained eruption, resulting in ashfall covering swaths of Ethiopia, Eritrea, and Yemen, darkening the landscape as seen from orbit. What was left behind in the aftermath was three deep explosion craters, the largest which is still degassing, measuring 1,365 feet wide, with the other two craters measuring 892 and 551 feet wide. Additionally, part of the summit subsided by an unknown amount, forming a series of cracks across a 1,300-meter-long and 1,050-meter-wide area. Then, the following day, a new pit crater formed at the Erda'el volcano, which measures 720 meters long and 410 meters wide. It is presumed that much of the Hayli Gubbi eruption utilized a magma dike Erda'el created last July that ran through the volcano, so this new pit crater could be linked to it. Or it could be linked to a new magma supply being sent to Hayli Gubbi again, we just don't know yet. Meanwhile, in Hawaii, after a 16-day wait, the Kilauea volcano produced another spectacular episode of sustained tall lava fountaining. Overflows of the summit vent in the southwestern section of its summit caldera occurred intermittently for several days until, at 2:30 p.m. on November 25th, sustained lava fountaining began. These lava fountains quickly grew in size, reaching their peak height only 30 minutes later, with heights of 600 feet or about 180 meters. Only the north vent was highly active, producing two distinct lava fountains which went in separate directions at an angle. Meanwhile, the south vent only produced occasional weak spattering and flaming via ignition of hydrogen gas. Fragments of tephra fell across much of the caldera floor, and across approximately 9.2 hours of eruptive activity, 6.3 million cubic meters of molten rock was added to the caldera floor. This total passes a threshold, meaning that Kilauea has now erupted more than 200 million cubic meters of lava during the last year. Based on the overall increasing trend between its eruptive episodes, Kilauea's next episode of lava fountaining will likely occur sometime between December 7th and December 18th. And in Indonesia, the alert level was once again raised at the Burni Telong volcano on the island of Sumatra due to an earthquake storm and the implied movement of magma beneath the lava dome complex that this volcano is named after. Magma also seemingly accumulated underneath the far northern section of an older volcanic complex, with only small bits of the magma ending up underneath Burni Telong proper. However, after November 25th, there have been no updates as a destructive and deadly natural disaster struck the region, Cyclone Sanar. This cyclone is the first in recorded history to have formed in the narrow Strait of Malacca between the Malay Peninsula and Sumatra. The storm then hovered over Sumatra for some time, dumping large volumes of rain. This not only caused severe flooding, but generated so many landslides and mudslides that it honestly, in some areas, looked like the aftermath of 2024's Hurricane Helene in North Carolina. Roads, homes, and bridges were washed away in Sumatra, and more than 300 fatalities occurred. As a result, access to the relevant volcano observatory monitoring Burney Telon is not currently possible, hence why we are somewhat in the dark of what is currently ongoing there underground. Here is a quick list of all the world's volcanoes which are currently erupting. Additionally, here are some volcanoes showing signs of unrest which are not erupting as of the recording of this video on November 29th of 2025. As a final note, I would like to thank my new YouTube channel member, Maggie H3480, for supporting my work.